Add that ratings dip to the ongoing controversy around player protests, and you might reasonably wonder how official NFL sponsors, as well as brands that buy advertising during NFL games, feel right now about the league. The answer, they're nervous, says Brian Cristiano, CEO of ad agency Bold Worldwide. Everyone is looking at the numbers, they're looking at the ratings, they're nervous. They're like, are we overpaying? What are we going to do? Can we have makeups? How else are we going to get this exposure back? In case you doubt that advertisers pay close attention to the week-to-week scandal and scrutiny in and around the league, Cristiano, who works with brands that advertise with the NFL, says they monitor all of this, probably too much to their detriment. They're looking at the press, they're looking at the ratings numbers, as if it really matters that much in the long run, instead of looking at next season, next year, and where the NFL is going to be in 3 to 5 years. And where is the NFL going to be in 3 to 5 years? Making its games available on more and more non-traditional platforms, if its deal this season to let Amazon stream 11 games is any indication. If you've been listening to our sportsbook podcast closely, Cristiano's point about advertisers anxiously monitoring contradicts what Elizabeth Lindsay of Wasserman said on episode 2 of the podcast. Scandals around the league rarely do much to ward off sponsors because of the NFL's reach. But in fact, both experts agree, the NFL isn't going anywhere. Look no further than the reaction from the 35 companies that are official NFL sponsors this season to what has been the biggest story in sports for 2 weeks, and one of the biggest ongoing news stories in the country, silence, almost across the board. Only 6, Under Armour, Nike, UB InBev, Ford, Hyundai, and Bose, have issued statements about President Donald Trump's condemnation of player protests, plus one, P&G, that responded when asked by News Pulse Finance. The NFL will continue to dominate American pro sports leagues, says Cristiano. But the NBA is nipping at its heels. I don't think they're going to overtake the NFL anytime soon, but the difference is the access level to the players, the personalities, in the NBA. Whereas in the NFL, it's all behind the shield, and that's not what fans want. So, what do fans want? Unfettered access to the athletes, not manufactured and processed by editing real, raw, stripped back. Instant engagement, access to the players, big personalities, they want real stuff, Cristiano says. And they want it in video format, for the most part. Daniel Roberts is the sports business writer at News Pulse Finance. Follow him on Twitter at ReadDanWrite. Sportsbook is our sports business video and podcast series. The growth in fantasy sports will not come from football, podcast episode 4. Economic benefits of new NFL stadiums are vastly overblown, podcast episode 3, football is football, why NFL scandals don't matter to NFL sponsors, podcast episode 2, Barstool Sports CEO, media outlets forgot they were consumer brands, podcast episode 1, inside the ugly breakup of Sports Illustrated, The Cauldron, and Chat Sports.